Good morning. Please be seated. Thank you. Good morning and welcome. I hope you all had a good Christmas and a happy new year to you all. Welcome to all those in church on Zoom and also joining us via YouTube. Very small few announcements today. Just to say thank you very much to everybody who's helped over Christmas and also over the last 6 months to keep this church going. There's a lot of work that goes in behind the scenes, and we're grateful to everybody who's contributed. And we've put a list of majority of people on the screen, so thank you. And just a reminder that on Tuesday evening at 8 o'clock, there is a prayer meeting that will be held by Zoom this week due to restrictions, etc. So the Zoom codes will be in the pews news, and if anybody wants to join us, please let me know. And I'd just like to welcome Michael Dunk back to our service today. Thank you, Michael, and enjoy the service. Thank you.
Sarah. Sarah's making her way back to her pew. There's one person missing from that long list that she wrote up there. There was a lot of people who helped to make this church run smoothly and well and make sure everything goes according to plan. Sarah is the queen pin behind most of it. Happens here, so I think we want to perhaps give her particularly a round of applause for all she's done. Thank you, Sarah. I'll add my Happy New Year to you all as we begin 2021, hopefully. Looking forward to a more hopeful and peaceful year as this virus hopefully will recede as the vaccinations take hold of our country. Let us worship God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. This is the day the Lord has made. Lord, direct our thoughts and teach us to pray. Lift up our hearts to worship you in spirit and in truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. First hymn we listen to is He is the Light. fun way to start the service, wasn't it? As Jesus shines a light onto our world and to our lives, perhaps we recognize the things that we do wrong that need Jesus' light to shine and show us the way. So we say sorry to God. God, our Father, we come to you in sorrow for our sins, for turning away from you and ignoring your will for our lives. Father, forgive us. Save us and help us. For behaving just as we wish, without thinking of you. Father, forgive us. Save us and help us. For failing you by what we do and say and think. Father, forgive us. Save us and help us. For letting ourselves be drawn away from you by temptations in the world about us. Father, forgive us. Save us and help us. For living as if we were ashamed to belong to your Son. Father, forgive us. Save us and help us. May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed is the Lord, for he has heard the voice of our prayer. Therefore shall our hearts dance for joy, and in our song we will praise our God. Amen. A hymn that's appropriate for the turning of the year, Lord, for the years.
This reading is taken from Ephesians, chapter 1, verses 3 to 14. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in the heavenly realms with every spiritual blessing in Christ. For he chose us in him before the creation of the world to be holy and blameless in his sight. In love, he predestined us to be adopted as his sons through Jesus Christ, in accordance with his pleasure and will, to the praise of his glorious grace, which he has freely given us in the one he loves. In him we have redemption, through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, in accordance with the riches of God's grace, that he lavished on us with all wisdom and understanding. And he made known to us the mystery of his will according to his good pleasure, which he purposed in Christ, to be put into effect when the times will have reached their fulfillment, to bring all things in heaven and on earth together under one head, even Christ. In him we were also chosen, having been predestined according to the plan of him who works out everything in conformity with the purpose of his will, in order that we, who were the first to hope in Christ, might be for the praise of his glory. And you also were included in Christ when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation. Having believed, you were marked in him with a seal, the promised Holy Spirit. He was a deposit guaranteeing our inheritance until the redemption of those who are God's possession, to the praise of his glory. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. There came a man who was sent from God. His name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all men might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who received him, to those who believed his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision, or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the only one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. John testifies concerning him. He cries out, saying, "This was he of whom I said, 'He who comes after me has surpassed me because he was before me.' From the fullness of his grace, we have all received one blessing after another. For the law was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. But God, the one and only, who is at the Father's side, has made him known." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. May I speak in the name of the living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. My son and his wife lived in Paris for many years, and one day they went to visit a restaurant. The slight difference to this restaurant was that it was totally blacked out and run entirely by blind people. So they were met at the door, taken to their table, and then the menu was read, spoken to them, and they had to choose fairly quickly which of the choices to make. Eventually the food came, and they had to find their way with their knife and fork around the plate, and it was a completely different experience for them. Of course, eating, some of the pleasure of eating is that we see the food they're about to eat. They didn't. But what they came away with is just a small experience of what it's like to be blind and not to see anything around you. Trying to get around in a room in complete darkness with no lights on can be disorientating. We can get a little out of our comfort zone. It is human nature to be anxious in darkness. John says, "The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it." If you take a light into a dark room, you will find that no matter where the room you put the light in, or no matter how small the light, the darkness can't hide the light. Once light enters a dark room, all can see it. And the light that John refers to is, of course, Jesus Christ. 200 years ago, the first oil lamp was invented with the equivalent of 9 candles of light. Well, the instruction book told its readers that it should be used only behind a screen. Such was the power of 9 candles that it was believed that it could ruin your eyesight. Well, how things have changed. My best present at Christmas ever, when I was a child, was an ex-army searchlight given to me by my parents in a green metal box with a very heavy battery, at least it seemed very heavy to me. Amongst the little additions was a tripod that I could stand it on and different colour filters, and also a sort of Morse code set that I could send out signals. And I was convinced that the searchlight could reach at least as far to the moon, if not further. Well, how naive I was about the strength of that searchlight. Someone once said that it is better to be saved by a lighthouse than a lifeboat. The first, of course, prevents an accident. The second is needed after an accident. Lighthouses have guided seafarers for centuries. The lighthouse near Plymouth is 133 feet high and can be seen over 13 miles away. The light at the top of the Statue of Liberty is over twice as high and, of course, can be seen a lot further away. In ancient times, one of the wonders of the world was a giant lighthouse near Alexandria. Its light could be seen 40 miles away. But whatever man builds, there is a limit to how far it can be seen. However good a person is, there is a limit to how far their influence can reach. The saintliest person that has ever lived has had his or her rays of light limited by both time and place. Jesus is the light of the world, without limit of time and space, not just for a short period in history 2,000 years ago in one small part of the world. John's Gospel tells us that Christ was with God when he created the world. He was there at the beginning of time. The last book in the Bible tells us that he will be there at the end of the world as well. The light of Christ is still in the world today and can be seen with the eye of faith. The wonderful colours of the rainbow can be seen because the sun's rays are both reflected and refracted by the rain. Light by itself is invisible. We only know of its existence, in the case of the rainbow, because we see it dispersed in the rain. We would not know what God is like if Jesus Christ had not lived on earth 2,000 years ago. He is God's reflection on earth. Jesus said, "He who's seen me has seen the Father." Light triumphs, not darkness. And that's what John makes clear. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. Jesus will triumph even in the darkest of times. We need to be reminded of this today because darkness appears in many forms and it also appears to be gaining ground on many fronts. When justice is divorced from morality, when the rights of individuals trump inappropriate behaviour, the only definition you have left for justice is the right for every individual to do as he or she pleases. When leadership in the community or the country uses power for their own ends, then people suffer. The end of that road is disorder and chaos. But the light continues to shine in the darkness, and the darkness will not overcome it, unless we let it. There's a famous painting by Holman Hunt, The Light of the World. It depicts Jesus knocking at the door of our lives. The door is overgrown with thorns and weeds. But if you know the painting, it has no handle on Jesus' side. We have to open it to let the light of Christ into our lives. He will never force his way in, nor will anyone else on your behalf be able to open it. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. So be of good cheer at the beginning of this new year. Christ has overcome the world of darkness. Believe in the light, so that you may become sons of light, wrote St. John. As we begin 2021, let the words of Minnie Louise Haskins be ours. I said to the man who stood at the gate of the year, give me a light that I may tread safely into the unknown. And he replied, go out into the darkness and put your hand into the hand of God. That shall be to you better than light and safer than a known way. We are all called to shine as a light in the world, however small and insignificant we think we may be. May God give us the grace and the determination to follow wherever he leads, and may he shine his light into the dark corners of his world and our lives too. Amen. We now listen to the hymn, The Call of Wisdom.
Guide us down the years till we see.
I invite you to stand for the Creed. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? We believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. I invite you to sit for the intercessions.
I've read recently that a prayer to God should say sorry, please, and thank you. And I've tried to organise my intercessions under these three headings today. The response to Lord, in your mercy, is hear our prayer. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
First of all, sorry. Lord God, we are sorry for when we haven't had you at the forefront of our minds, in our thoughts, our words, and our actions. We are sorry for when we weren't strong enough to stand up for what was important, for when we were too lazy or tired to do your work, or for when we procrastinated. Perhaps we didn't volunteer to do something when it would really have made a difference. Perhaps we didn't put ourselves out of our comfort zone to do your work. Perhaps we have made the choice to tell ourselves that we are too busy, too poor, or too tired. It's not for us, or I'll do it if no one else does it. Help us to use our initiative and take responsibility to do your work. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord God, we are sorry that we haven't given more of ourselves to you. Actions speak louder than words. We're sorry for when we have paid lip service to things that we then didn't go out into the world and promote. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Secondly, please. Please be with us, Lord. Lord God, help us to call on you. There is a post doing the rounds on social media that jokes, nobody call 2021 as your year. Tiptoe in quietly. Don't touch anything. Lord God, as we embark on 2021, help us to manage our expectations. As we learn to cope with the tough times that lie ahead, help us to look to you to guide us in what we do and to remember that you are with us even in our darkest hours. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord God, help us not to judge others. When we see others driving to what we consider to be our countryside for their exercise in Tier 4, help us not to judge them. When we see people stockpiling things in the supermarkets just in case Brexit's arrival might lead to shortages, help us not to judge them. When we pass others on our walks and count the number of people in their bubbles, shaking our heads in disbelief, help us not to judge them. When politicians impose, withdraw, and renege on laws and decisions in a constant juggle between economy, health, and education, help us not to judge them. Instead, help us to remember that everyone is on their own journey. Some people are afraid. Some are battling huge anxieties. Help us not to be ignorant and proud, but to try to see things from others' point of view. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord God, help us to be loving and giving. They say a team is only as strong as its weakest member, and so a community can only be as strong as those people who make it up. Help us to pay attention to those in need, not to seek gratitude, but to know that we are carrying out the work that you intend for us. Help us to be active in our loving and giving. Help us to give to food banks, drop friendly cards through our neighbours' doors, put our names down on church and community rotas, and be pioneers of positivity. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord God, help us to pray for our schools and teachers and the children and parents in our community and beyond. As schools face further disruption and potential closure, as children face more homeschooling and some face more time away from the only stable constant in their lives, as teachers embark on managing continually changing government and learning expectations, and parents struggle with balancing jobs and children at home. As part of our prayer cycle, we pray for the staff and tutors of Juniper Hall and the friends of Juniper Hall who help to support its work. Help us to remember the power of prayer, and that when you are walking the walk, help us to remember the power of prayer and that you are walking the walk alongside us. As the poem, The Footsteps in the Sand, says, when we see only one set of footprints in the sand, it is not that we are alone, but instead it is then that you are carrying us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord God, help us to see the big global picture. We pray for our world and for those countries in great need of democracy. We pray for the USA and its political turbulence as Trump prepares to leave the White House on the 20th of January. We pray for third world countries that crave stability and peace. As part of our prayer cycle, we pray for the country of Japan as we embark on a new year. We pray for those people who are refugees and need our compassion and care. Help us to join up the dots and recognize how our small actions can impact wider policies and decision making. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord God, help those who are sick or who have died, those who are in hospital or at home, those who are suffering with their mental health or their physical health. Let us take a moment to pray for God's help and blessing on those known to us personally. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And now a very big thank you. Lord God, thank you for everything positive that has happened. Thank you for the fact that there are vaccines now being administered for COVID. Thank you for the way our community has pulled together to support those who are vulnerable. Thank you for our visiting clergy and our church wardens, our PCC and all our helpers who are keeping our church operational during our interregnum. Thank you for all the small actions and charitable acts that are quietly undertaken by many in our community. Thank you for those who gave up their Christmas Day to deliver food to others in need. Thank you to those providing friendship and support for those who need it. Thank you for family. Thank you for friends. Thank you for Zoom and technology. However much it may leave some of us baffling over why the sound isn't working, it has enhanced our lives. My children would like to add thank you for Christmas, thank you for our homes, and thank you for people who have saved others' lives. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Blessing, honour, and glory be yours, here and everywhere, now and forever. Amen. Another hymn that's appropriate for this time of the year is God is working his purpose out.
Thank you.
As we begin this new year, we ask God's blessing upon us. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of our Son, of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be amongst you and remain with you and those you love, this day and forevermore. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.